Have you ever been confused about which way to go in life? Who do you trust to direct your path? Sometimes choices can be difficult. Should I study for a test or go play basketball instead? Should I practice for my piano lesson or go watch Duck Dynasty or whatever your favorite TV show is? As Christians, the devil is always trying to get us to make the wrong choice. For example, teenagers are constantly being targeted by Satan to steal from their classmates, to use bad language, and to drink alcohol, among other things. We have to decide whom we are going to follow. And that's a fact, Jack. Joshua was the very brave commander of the Israelite army in the Old Testament. He led the Israelites to victory in many battles. In Joshua 1:16, he told the Lord, "All that you have commanded us, we will do, and wherever you send us, we will go." Joshua did exactly what God told him to, and for this reason, he was successful in defeating his enemies. Later in Joshua's life, he wanted the people of Israel to remember the importance of being true to the Lord. He said in Joshua 24:15, "And if it is evil in your eyes to serve the Lord, choose this day whom you will serve, whether it be the gods your father served in the region beyond the river, or the gods of the Amorites in whose land you dwell. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord." Joshua really understood what God had done for the people of Israel, and he was committed to serving the one and only true and living God. Several years ago, my class took a field trip to the Carn Plantation. We learned about the Battle of Franklin that took place during the Civil War on November 30th, 1864. The Confederate Army of Tennessee furiously assaulted the Union Army, entrenched along the southern edge of Franklin. The battle that followed lasted 5 hours and resulted in 9,500 soldiers either being killed, wounded, captured, or missing. Nearly 7,000 of that number were Confederate troops. The majority of the combat took place in the dark and in tight quarters. The Carn Plantation was converted into a field hospital for the wounded and dying. After hearing this story, I had to wonder why men would charge into such a battle when the odds were against them. It's because they were fighting for a cause that they believed in and following orders from their commanding general. God is our commanding general. And unlike earthly men, he will never lead us down the wrong path. In Proverbs 3, 5-6, the Bible says, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your path." I'm also reminded of a story about my father and uncle, who's actually here tonight. One day, several years ago, they were fishing down the Buffalo River. As they went down the river in their boat, they came to a fork. On the left, the water was very wide and very shallow. And on the right, the water was blocked by a huge tree lying across the river. But on the other side of the tree, the river looked deep and very swift, not to mention filled with rapids, a perfect place for fish to live. My dad and uncle had a decision to make. Which way would they go? After looking at both options, my uncle finally said, "Well, we came here to fish, didn't we?" So they lifted their boat up over the tree and went the way that looked dangerous and difficult. Some might say this was a crazy decision. Why go the hard way? Well, they had to go the way that was going to help them meet their goal of catching fish. Likewise, for us as Christians, we must choose the route in life that will help us meet our ultimate goal, heaven. Just like Joshua and so many others in the Bible, we must make choices that are based on trusting God's wisdom and not our own. It won't always be easy, and sometimes people will make fun of us, but it will be worth everything to spend eternity in heaven with God.